Okay, the reproduction procedure is going to ask the turtles to create copies of themselves. And we use the hatch procedure to get the turtles to reproduce. So I'm going to say, ask each turtle to hatch two turtles. And by default, those turtles will have all of the attributes of their parents. Now, I mentioned earlier that we're going to have to keep track of generations. That involves giving the turtles a custom variable. And we call those turtles' own variables. And I'm going to call one a generation. So now, when we create a turtle with a setup procedure, or anytime we create a turtle, it would automatically have a variable called generation. And when these little hatchlings arrive on the scene, they're going to have that variable too. And it's going to automatically be set to the same level as to the same value that the parents variable is set to, but we don't want that. We want they're the next generation, right? So we want them to set their generation to here we have to use a generation of myself plus one. So I think that this might have to be in square brackets. So basically, we're setting the stuff that follows after the hatch command is the commands that are issued to the newly arrived hatchlings. And the only thing I'm going to do with them differently is I'm going to set their generation to whatever the generation of myself is. That's the myself is the one that is outside of these square bracket plus one. So basically, I'm just incrementing that. Now, if it sounds like I am a little unsure of that, whether I don't know if these square brackets need to be there, two things I could do. One thing, I could look at the quick help for myself and see, yeah, sure enough, it does have to be in the square brackets. They're using it there. And this explains the difference between self and myself, which is when you have time sometime, go ahead and read that. I think that this should work. So we're going to hatch two and set them. Now, just so that we can see them, let's set their color to red and have them go forward three. That way we can just check and see if this reproduce thing works. So let's try going back here. I'm going to comment this out for now, just so we can test the code we've gotten so far. Now we set up and we step, and it looks to me like every turtle has. Let's do a smaller population just so we can see. We'll set up with just five turtles. Step. We don't see. It doesn't seem to. Oh, I see. Yeah. I'm guessing that these inherited the heading of the parent as well. So, 1, 2, 3, 4. Sometimes it's confusing when you're doing these kind of models because you don't know exactly how many turtles you have. So you could just do a simple thing in the command thing where you say count, show count of turtles. Because it looks to me here like there's just, you know, 10 turtles or so. But when I look here, there's 15. So yeah, indeed, we have some turtles that are overlapping. Another way you can do this is you can click on that and you can see that turtle 11 and 12 are actually coincident there. So yeah, so this is working. The hatchlings are also inheriting the heading from their parent, which is makes them overlap. But we're going to disperse them later on anyway, so we don't need to worry about that now. So reproduction works. Now we might want to see if the generation business works. So let's take a look back here at the interface. If we inspect this turtle, we should see that it has a generation variable. And I don't see it. And let's see if this one does. Well, it's not there, so we have to see something's gone awry here. So let's see. Let's comment this out again. Run setup. Inspect this turtle. Sure enough, maybe I hadn't set up, but there we have the generation. So this is generation 0. Turtle 3 is of generation 0. And when we step, we should be able to look at one of these, and with any luck, it will be of generation 1. So we're incrementing the generation. I don't know if you can see this, but the generation was 1, or a 0 on the original green turtles, and now it's 1. So our generation feature is working. Okay, now we're going to ask the parents to die. You know, it occurs to me we're going to have to keep track of which generation we're on, too. So that's going to require, that's a global kind of function. So we're going to make a global variable called current generation. And every time we step, we're also going to increment the current generation. So, and this will allow us to keep track of who should die when. So every time we do a step, we're going to take this number, which starts out at 0, and we're going to add 1 to it. So reproduce. And now we're going to say to make the parents die. Ask turtles. And this is we're going to ask the turtles with generation less than or equal to the current generation to and this is a great thing to do in NetLogo. You create these agent sets, but you can talk to partial agent sets. So I don't want to talk to all of the turtles. I only want to talk with those turtles who have a personal generation variable, a turtle zone variable, that's less than or equal to the current generation to die. I'm not sure. I think maybe I just mean less than. We'll see if this is what I mean or not. Okay, so we're going to ask them to die. Okay, so let's go back here and set up step. And it looks like let's instead of setting these things to red, let's set these to just a random number, let's say a random number up to 100. That'll mean they're different colors. And we're going to also go forward a random number. That way we should be able to see them. This is just temporarily, so we can do this. Okay. So we're seeing the different generations and the populations are growing. You can see the colors are changing. Anyway, what this is telling me is that the different generations are coming by. We can inspect one of these fellows here. There's lots of turtles now. So let's inspect turtle 20,000. We're only at generation 12, but we already have we've hatched over 20,000 turtles. So of course that's how exponential population growth works, right? So okay. Now let's look. We've got the parents dying. Now the whole point of this is we need to have some kind of constraint, some sort of thing that makes it difficult, so that there can't be unlimited reproduction or unlimited growth. One way to do that, and the easiest way to do that, is to create a situation where population or individuals die off. Depending upon how crowded the conditions are. So parents die, and now let's call this compete with nature. This is an idea from evolutionary biology that that individuals compete with each other, and that they also compete with the environment in a certain way. And this is a case where they're kind of competing with each other. For space, but they are the environment too. So, actually, I'm going to change that. I don't like that. I'm going to call it compete for space. Okay. So,